All right, everybody, so welcome back. This is Aaron Utley. I'm live from the 2016 X-Wing Regional Championship at your hobby place in Martinsburg, West Virginia. And we have pulled Mark Lee Ligon from Havre de Grace, Maryland. He is running Bosque with Only Opportunist, Menaru with the Tawny Mind Link, K4, Unhinged Astromech, Plasma Torpedoes, Extra Munitions, and Guidance Chips, and Palob. Interesting to see a Hawk, a little bit of variety. We've got Mind Link on him as well, and Dorsal Turret. So over on the right side, we have a... he's not from Arlington. From Glen Burnie, Maryland. We have Steel Enterprises Stream Regular, Jeremy Howard. Glen Burnie, Maryland. And he is running his PAL Paces list with 35-point Fell, Inquisitor with PTL with the title and auto thrusters, and an Omicron group shuttle with Palpatine and Senso Jamal. Harris in chat, thank you for the kind words. Appreciate it. We try. It's a little more dull when it's just me. But what can you do? I'm who you get. So I've got so we're looking forward to some good matchups here. Another four hours of X-Wing, because, I mean, who doesn't need to be here all day long? So I will actually go ahead, since we got a little bit of time, I will pull some of these things up to give those of you who might know, including me, a rundown of what we're looking at. Right. So Bosque's pilot ability I'm actually sort of familiar with. When you perform an attack that hits before dealing damage, you may cancel one of your crit results to add two hit results. You can kind of opt to do that as the situation dictates, which is always interesting. And Menaru, at the start of the combat phase, you may assign all focus, evade, and target lock tokens assigned to you to another friendly ship. Let me find Mind Link, and I'll read that as well. Where are you? Here we go, Tawny Mind Link. Each time you're assigned a focus or stress token, either each other friendly ship with a Tawny Mind Link must also be assigned the same type of token if it does not already have one. So they will be passing them back and forth between Menaru and Palop. Palob, PS5 Hawk, at the start of the combat phase, you may remove one focus or evade token from an enemy ship at range 1 and 2 and assign it to yourself, which works a nice synergy with Menaru with the Mind Link there. So lots of focus tokens flopping around this way and that. I did not catch who has initiative here, but it doesn't really matter. We don't have any... don't have any conflicts. We've I've seen plenty of K4, Torps, and Guidance chips. Unhinged Astromech, one that you don't always see. I believe that makes your threes green. Turns all your threes green. Yay! The Capitals scored, so New Washington's now up on the Pittsburgh Penguins 2-1.
Yeah, what's up? What kind of software do you use to stream the Twitch feed and...
This is just OBS. You can open broadcast software. You can download it right off the Twitch page.
Cool. I want to give that a try. You've inspired me.
Interface. Good.
I want to do this at Curio.
It just takes some tinkering.
I got a good microphone. Is that a USB mic?
Yeah, it's a crap mic, but it works. Did you guys start time? Okay, time started. Jeremy's fell with a hard push down the lower end of the mat there, and a boost. And a barrel roll. Might be looking to really quickly get back in behind Bosque. That will be trouble for Bosque. Bosque with a big fat arc, though, doesn't need to do a whole lot to avoid that in the short term. And we're into dials for the second turn. like a two forward for Jeremy Shuttle and the Focus. Here goes Manaru with a bank in to the right. Checking for target lock. Nobody's in range. And a two hard from Palob. So a real quick adjustment by Markley to head off that flanking attempt. Nope. Looks like he's into the debris and will be in the debris next turn as well. It's not a crit, so he takes stress, but no damage. Jeremy's Inquisitor. One turn to the right. So, pretty clever. Jeremy got everybody turned to the right, and then he turned his Inquisitor in sharply. He's going to barrel roll. Not sure if that gets him clear of Manor's arc or not. Tricky angle from here. There's a four forward for Fell, and I imagine we'll see a boost round to the right here. Jeremy's looking and thinking. Boost. So it looks like Bosk and Fell will exchange, will trade fire here in a moment. So Jeremy's shooting at Palob here. Two hits. He rolls two evades. Is an Inquisitor shot at Manaru. Markley only needed one of eight and he rolled it. Moss has got a range two shot here on Fell. And Fell uses his focus for three of eights. That should take us to Palop. Got a range three primary on Fell. Good luck with that. One hit. One of eight. Looks like Manor's got a range three shot. Two hits. Two of eights. So we'll clean up, move on to the next turn. Those guys set up. I'll take a look at the. I didn't play today, but I got a tasty little haul from the guys at your hobby place. I got a nice set of regionals range rulers that they had made from Litco. A nifty little wooden key tag deal with the Your Hobby Place logo on it. I got a Green Goblin alt art card. A nifty little Poe Dameron button. And a cool little comic book size Poe Dameron litho. It's kind of neato. So some cool swag to not even have played from the folks here at your hobby store, your hobby place.
What's up? I just saw your question about the logo.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Still need that?
I mean, I could put it up here if you want it.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, send it to me. I'll put it up. Washington scored again. They're now up 3-1 on the Penguins. Hooray! So much pondering. Who is being pondered here? Manaru. Okay. Let's reponder Palop. I have a feeling that Sentry Fell is about to chew Palop up. Two bank keeps his focus. Thank you. There's a one bank from Manaroo. And a target locked. Palab, and what has three yard to the left, so he's not going to clear stress, he's going to gain another one, he's going to roll for a crit. Nope, rolls a blank, so he's fine there. Looks like Jeremy's Inquisitor and Fell are both going to try and go to work here on Palab. Jeremy's going to roll into range one to avoid a torpedo shot. That's a little bit of a surprise. So center engages Manaroo range 3. Token shenanigans with Palab and Mind Link and take tokens from Fell and token swap shenanigans. Manaroo takes two. Two shields come off. Three hits on Palab, an Inquisitor. Two evades, takes one shield. cleaning up and back to the end of the turn. Fells dials down. Jeremy's set down his Inquisitor dial. Looks like Murphy's sorting out Palab's maneuver. Looks like everybody's dials are down. Just double checking real quick. All right, here goes Jeremy's shuttle. It's a two turn. Very nice. Takes a stress for the two turn, but he clogs up that space really well. Manero one turn to the right. Like Palab is target lock the Inquisitor. Bosk with a three turn left. Jeremy with a one turn to the right on his Inquisitor, debating his follow-on actions. Both Palab and Bosk have the Inquisitor locked. So he'll take that target lock, get his evade, push limit, focus, and stress. So there's a two turn for Fell. He's going to clear stress. Palov deciding who's going to snatch tokens from. He's going to take the evade token from the Inquisitor and apply it to himself. So, range 2 into Palov from Sunterfell. He's going to focus for 3 hits. He rolls 1 evade. He spends his token for 1 damage. One face down damage card for Palov. Jeremy Cheese. Alright, so that's Bosk shooting at the Inquisitor. He's going to spin his target lock, reroll that blank. Rolls the blank again, so it's 2. And Jeremy rolls a bunch of evades. Dorsal turret on Palov. 2 hits. So, auto thrusters gives him 2 evades. Meru range 1 into. Doesn't have a focus token, so it's 2 hits. Auto thrusters and Palpatine for 2 evades. And that'll be Jeremy Shuttle. So 3 hits. So it's a hit and a crit into Palov. Alright, so the crit is damage sensor array, so Palov won't be performing any actions until he can get that resolved and flipped over. Clean up and moving into the next turn. Jeremy's downs are down. UA is unhinged astromech. in front of me. Steve Dodd just eliminated Frank Forte. Question in chat is, what is Steve Dodd flying? Steve's flying the list he won the SEAL Open with last week, his Zuckuss and two Scouts. Manaroo cannot decide what he wants to do. Down. So let's see Jeremy Shuttle. It's a one bank. I don't believe he fits in there, so he'll bump. Sitting on that debris, so he'll lose stress, he'll regain stress, and he'll roll to see if he picks up a crit. Rolls an eyeball. Manaroo with a one turn. So they've called over Garrett T.O. to make that placement. Conferring a little bit, and there he is. There's a bump for Manaroo. Now let's see what Palob has done. Mark has sort of flown all of his ships back at each other here and jammed himself up a little bit. And there's Palob. Three straight, he overflies that debris, so he's going to take stress. And he's going to roll. Takes a crit. And that destroys him. Jeremy with much fist pumping. The question now is, Pella picked up stress. So would that give Manaru stress before it was destroyed? Garrett's reading the Mind Link card. Question is, did he get the stress before it was destroyed? Because if he gets the stress before he rolls for damage, then Manaru gets stress as well. So we're going to take a look. So the Teal's ruling is that the stress kicks in first, so due to Mind Link, Manaru receives the stress as well. Manaru. Lots of moving of things and things being moved. Stack of ships. And Sunterfell. Where are you going, Sunterfell? And he's going to barrel roll. Try and get out of torp range. Well, it doesn't really matter. Manaru doesn't have any way to shoot at him anyway. He's asking Teo to check Arc. The Inquisitor does have Arc on Bossk. What is the ruling? So Inquisitor shoots at Bossk at range 2. Or 1. Mm-hmm. Takes two shields off Bossk. It's a range two shot from Bossk into the Inquisitor now. Two hits. Two evades. Evades that cleanly. Manaru shot. It's a range one shot on the Inquisitor. One. Another evade from Inquisitor. Range one from the shuttle into Bossk. And he still has his Palpatine effect, so he's going to roll one of these into a crit. So two hits and a crit into Bossk. Rolls an eyeball, so he takes all three. And he has one shield left on Bossk. Like Marcus still debating Bossk's maneuver. There it goes.
What's going on?
What's up?
Good day.
Did you win?
Perfect game. No shields lost.
Nice.
How are you doing?
Okay.
What's the damage situation?
It's Jeremy's game at this point.
Really? Nice.
I'm not sure he's taking any damage. So that's Phil eliminated now. Okay, so Duncan Howard just came by, and he has just eliminated Phil Baraniak, so he's out. So, Duncan Howard and Steve Dodd have advanced to the semifinals. There's Manaru's maneuver. It's a green maneuver because of unhinged astromech, so it removes stress. What's that? Oh, that's, well, I mean, that's nothing new for them. And here goes Bossk. Chat is awfully quiet. Are you guys all still there? And Inquisitor with a one bank. So I think he's going to bump right there. Which actually suits him just fine. Center fell. With a two bank. And a boost. And start coming back around. And a roll back into the right. There's a stress and a focus for foul. Looks like he's checking range on Manaru. I believe it's range 2. One hit. Manaru's down to one shield. Hit crit into Bosk. He's going to ask him to reroll that. It's an eyeball. He spends it for an evade, so he takes a crit. Nope. Okay, it was one crit, so he doesn't. Clean up, back to Dials. He should have Fell back around here in a second. Frank. Just this one. Not mine. It's this one. Okay. I mean, I can kind of hear you guys, but not really. All right, and there's a sloop from Manaru. I believe that was a focus. He stops. Looks like Jeremy was wise to that and took a one turn to the right. Debating his options. He's going to barrel roll. He's going to target lock Bosk to get that evade. Is he going to boost fell here? Does boost and evades. Dig. Boss has taken his range one shot on the Inquisitor. He spins his target lock and then his focus. And Inquisitor shields there. Range 3 obstructed. And range 3 obstructed into the shuttle. Two die primary at range 3 into who? The shuttle he missed. So the shuttle shooting range 2 at Bosk. Hit crit. There was an eyeball, so he takes all three. Bosk is now just took a crit, and all of his turns are now red. Checking his dials. Thank you. unbanked from Jeremy onto some debris. Looks like he squeezes in there. Question is how much time? I think Garrett just said 18 minutes. Manaroo. It's two straight. He target locks Inquisitor. Bosque with a one bank to the right. Jeremy's Inquisitor. Looks like a one turn to the left. Looks like he's going to try and focus some fire on Bosque and get him off the board. Two straight for Sunterfell. He just takes a load of tokens there. Okay, he's going to shoot Manaroo range 2. Bosque has only one hull left, so he's pretty confident he can ramp that up. Another good roll from Jeremy, three hits. Manor rolls one eyeball. Mark takes all three, I guess we can get his torpedo away here. Inquisitor range 1 Bosque. Well, that kills Bosque. He can't evade more than one, and there's three hits. So that puts two more on Bosque, and he's off the board. So Manaroo is left with three hull. Looks like he's going to shoot torpedoes at the Inquisitor. So Manaroo fires plasma torpedoes, guidance chips. So he uses his evade and his focus and evades him cleanly. Shuttle into Manaroo. Range 1. Still has his Palpatine, so he will roll one of those into a crit. So a hit and a crit. One evade, so he takes a crit. Thrust control fire, so stress on Manaroo, and we'll go to what may be the last turn of the game.
Tell
So Manners dials down. Quizzer's dials down. Fells dials down. And the shuttle. Left, but I believe this will probably resolve the game as Manaru has only two hull left and will probably not survive the turn. Looks like a bump. I think Jeremy has taken one shield off the Inquisitor, maybe. I'm not certain, though. So there's a bump. Manaru. There's a three bank, which is going to be green, thanks to Unhinged Astromech. So shed stress. Target lock the shuttle. And that's his. Then his actual action is a focus. Get a one turn. Does that put him in arc? He does. Target locks, gets his evade. Two forward bump from Sunterfell. But he should be able to wrap this up. I don't know if his Inquisitor has arc on him, though. Range 2 for Sunterfell. Unmodified dice. Looks like hit an eyeball and a blank. So rolls that into Palpatine to a hit and a crit. He rolls one eyeball. So he spends his focus, takes one crit. Direct hit. Nope, it's not a direct hit. So three coming from Inquisitor, that's the game. Two evades, but that takes it. So Jeremy Howard has eliminated Mark Biligan in the quarterfinal round. And I will turn the audio off here, and we will be back in just a few minutes with semifinals.